Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and over the past week or so, we've had a lot of different information come out about upcoming iPhone 12s, as well as the next Apple event, which takes place this coming Tuesday. And so I wanted to talk about iOS 14.0.1. I'm running that on my iPhone 11 Pro, and then also talk about iOS 14.2 Beta 2 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and talk about when to expect the next versions as well, as I thought some of them would already be out, but Apple seemingly changed it up this time. And so the first thing is, with iOS 14.0.1, some people are still having some issues, but the main issue for a lot of people is battery. Now, Apple actually acknowledged this and gave us a fix for it, which isn't the greatest fix, but it's basically restore your device using a Mac or Windows computer and then restore all of your data. And if you do that, chances are your battery will improve greatly. In fact, I've heard from quite a few of you that have done that, and after doing that, battery was phenomenal for a lot of people. But seemingly, this is not a great fix, and in fact, most people probably should not do that. In fact, most people should probably just wait for Apple to update it, unless your battery is so bad that you just can't get through the day. I've heard from some of you on everything from iPhone 7 to iPhone 10. It doesn't really seem to matter, and we're not really sure exactly what's causing it, but it seems like some devices, just for some reason, have to be charged twice a day, and then sometimes they don't. So my devices have been okay. They haven't been phenomenal. They've been okay, but getting through the day sometimes is not a problem. Other times it is, depending on the device. And the other problem I hear with iOS 14.0.1 is LTE, or connectivity for some. Now, this has long been an issue due to non-Qualcomm modems, or basically Intel modems, which is expected to be fixed with a hardware update to Qualcomm with the iPhone 12 launch. But unfortunately, that's not going to fix the issue for us that we've actually had decent connectivity depending on the device. So if you are having problems with that, hopefully Apple pushes a modem update with their next version and then fixes that. Now, with the public version of 14.0.1, I'm running that on my iPad, and mostly it's been okay for me. But on my iPad Pro, I had a couple different issues today. So after running this for over a week without any problems, really, I actually had to reset it or restart it because it just wasn't working properly. So the first thing was, I was using my magic keyboard here like I normally do, and all of a sudden it just wouldn't type into certain fields in iMessage and other places. And then the other thing is, when I went to set this wallpaper that I have here, it wouldn't allow me to set the wallpaper. I would hit the share sheet or the action to actually set it, and nothing would come up. It would be a blank share sheet. And I'm hearing that from multiple people, not just on iPads, but on iPhone as well. So you could go into your photos, go to share this, and nothing would pop up, or go to set it as wallpaper and nothing would pop up. So for some reason, it's doing that for some people. Thankfully for myself, it seemingly worked after I restarted the device, but those are small bugs that should be fixed by now and hopefully will be fixed by the next update. Now, also with iOS 14.0.1, most people are saying performance is good. They're not really complaining about it. In fact, everything seems to load nice and fast. That includes games. But some people are still complaining about heat with the phone. They're asking for an update to fix the heating issues with the phone. It's just seemingly getting more warm or hotter than it should be, or that they've noticed with previous updates. So there's something with this update that's causing the processor to work a little bit harder and get warmer. So we're really waiting for that update, which I'll talk about in a little bit. Now, with iOS 14.2 Beta 2, well, this particular update has been a couple weeks going pretty well. In fact, it's been great as well with performance. I've really had no issues here. Everything seems nice and fast. Applications are running well. I really have not had a whole lot of crashes. And AirDrop is working great for me. That's between macOS Catalina and macOS Big Sur. So it seems like most of the major issues are fine. You'll see the camera seems to work fast. I haven't had any performance issues. I personally haven't had any warming issues with 14.2 Beta 2, and I haven't really noticed any issues at all. In fact, it's been one of the best betas in a long time. Now, the odd thing is 14.1 is missing, so hopefully we'll see that soon. But as far as 14.2 Beta 2, looking through the different comments and things with iOS 14, which we'll take a look at in a moment, they've been pretty good. But let's take a look at my battery life, since that's what most people are interested in at this point that are coming from iOS 14.0.1. So if we go into my settings, we'll go down to battery, My battery health is at 94%. It's fairly consistent. It's over a year old, so that's pretty good. We'll go to the last 10 days, and you'll see yesterday I used about 45% of my battery life, and I got 4 hours and 14 minutes of screen on time, 23 minutes of screen off time. The previous day, similarly, 4 hours and 41 minutes, 1 hour and 43 minutes of screen off time, and I used less than 50%. That means I'm getting closer to the 9 or 10 hours that would be expected with this device. 10 or 12 is ideal, and as you adjust things like the home and lock screen, I've tried a few tweaks, which I'll have in a battery update video very soon, but this specific update seems to be much better on battery life for me, especially if you adjust different notifications that are triggering the lock screen to turn on and things like that. So it seems to be a very solid update, and I think most people will be happy with it once it's finally released. And speaking of releases, iOS 14.0.2 never came out this past week. In fact, many of us expected it to release to the public on all of the supported devices, but Apple never released it. All they did was release tvOS 14.0.2. But it seems like, given that the Apple event is on Tuesday, they're probably going to skip it and go right to 14.1, which is what many people suspected would be coming with the iPhone 12 launch. So whether it be 14.0.2 or iOS 14.1 on Tuesday, I would expect an update that soon, Tuesday or Wednesday this week, where we see iOS 14.1 with maybe some new features as well. And they probably didn't want to show that code off to show off what's in the newest iPhones. So of course I'll keep you updated as soon as we see that event, and I'll be talking about that later on, but I think we're going to have that update. And given that we're on a 2-week cycle, we may see iOS 14.2 betas. Of course, Apple could do something crazy and skip iOS 14.1 altogether and jump right to 14.2. Hopefully they don't do that, but if they don't, we probably will see beta 3 this week also, based on that 2-week cycle. Apple has really been changing these updates out really kind of in an odd way. We haven't seen this before. Last year with iOS 13, they were just pushing out updates over and over so fast that it was really kind of surprising. Now it seems a little bit more stable. They're taking more time to get things right, I hope, and we should see those released on time, I would think, this coming week. We may also see a watchOS 7.1 as well to coincide with it, but we'll have to wait and see. And then, of course, there's macOS Big Sur, which we haven't seen yet, and hopefully Apple gives an announcement, but based on recent information, it seems like November there's going to be another announcement of the Apple Silicon-based Macs, where they have their own Apple chipsets in them instead of Intel chips. So maybe they won't release macOS until then. Apple hasn't said a word about it, so hopefully we'll hear about that pretty soon or on Tuesday. Now, other than that, let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and see what you had to say, since it's been a couple weeks with over 20,000 votes on each version of iOS. So let's take a look. Now, as you can see, iOS 14.2 beta 2, I posted this a week or so ago, and it had 22,000 votes. 16% of you are saying that it's great. Only 5% are saying it's terrible, which is actually okay for a beta. 8% of you are saying okay, but some bugs, and 59% of you are on the previous version that's currently out, and 11% of you are using an older version of iOS. If we take a look at 14.0.1, apparently 50% of you say it's great, 5% say it's terrible again, with 26,000 votes. 24% of you are saying it has bugs, which we know there are definitely some bugs in it, and then 14% of you never updated at all, and 7% of you are on really old versions. So that's quite a lot of information here. Let's take a look at some of the comments, and we'll take a look at some of the comments first for 14.0.1. There's 696 comments, but let's take a look at some of the newest ones. I Do Everything Once says, my camera is being very glitchy and super slow almost every day, just waiting for the next update. Rinal Pradeep says, I'm having the volume issue when I'm using the ear pods while listening to music. I get a call, and after it ends, the volume becomes extremely low, even though it's at full volume. I have also turned off reduced sound levels, but in order to increase it, it will need to turn that on, and heating issues. When I use the phone, it tends to heat a lot, iPhone 7 Plus. And again, I see more about the phone getting hot the longer the update's been out. So again, Anand says, heat while using browsing, We'll take a look at a couple more for this version. Dead Wolf King says, major, major problem. I can't use Face ID. Many other people are unable to use it. I'm using iPhone XS. And this has become more of a recent problem I've heard of with people having issues with Face ID. Now, whether or not they've replaced their screen, which is causing this issue, I'm not sure. But it does seem to be happening on people that just updated to it where it was working before. But this seems to be few and far between, but there are a number of people complaining about it. And then bug in YouTube Safari to be picture in picture. Picture in picture again was turned off by YouTube unless you're a premium subscriber. So you can use Safari again if you want to use YouTube with picture in picture, but you have to be a YouTube premium subscriber in order to do that. And then let's take a look at two more for this version, then we'll look at the other one. Josh Miller said there's been some weird animation glitches here and there, specifically in music and on the lock/home screen for me. Besides that, pretty good. And then finally, Tony Allen says the calendar isn't consistent for the iPhone X. Sometimes you can change the date and time and other times you can't. The only workaround I've seen on it is that you have to save the event you're working on, then re-enter it and change the date to the time that what you may want it to be. So this seemingly has a lot of weird little bugs that are not consistent for every single person. Now with iOS 14.2 betas, let's take a look at some of the comments here. We'll go to newest first. And the first comment says, WhatsApp crash. And I'm seeing this consistently across different devices. I forgot to mention it earlier, but WhatsApp is still having an issue and they need to update their app, or something changed on Apple's end that causes these issues with video and things like that. So hopefully they'll resolve that soon. Again, here's another person, Carlos, that says the same thing. iPhone 11, I'm not able to see videos on WhatsApp since installing iOS 14.2 beta 2. Sansa B says, I'm also having a bug, like my phone screen freezes for at least 20 to 30 seconds while playing games at least once a day. I'm using iPhone 11 Pro Max. Diamond says, it's been really great and smooth all over, but I've been having trouble with picture-in-picture mode. And like I mentioned earlier, that could be because you don't have YouTube Premium or you're not signed in if you're using Safari. Hopefully they'll enable it in the YouTube app as well fairly soon. TechOut says, no issues after the iPad charging issue was fixed. With Beta 1, I had major charging issues I did a separate video on, and thankfully that's fixed with Beta 2. Madeline says, best version so far, I didn't find any bugs yet. Mohammed says, I'm using it on iPhone 7 Plus, and it's okay, nothing is wrong. And we'll look at one more. Let's take a look, and we'll see here. I have an iPhone 6S and sometimes out of nowhere, it'll shut off and cut back on by itself. Make sure to check your battery health and hopefully that's fixed. And I do see one more here where it says iOS 14.1 beta 2. I think you mean iOS 14.2 beta 2 runs okay, but I've lost about 2 hours of screen on time for my battery and some apps seem to crash. So again, none of these are going to be perfect, but hopefully Apple releases something this week. I really expect them to release an update this week. It's been a long time, it seems like, and it's definitely time for a public release, at least to fix all of these minor bugs and some more major like battery. Issuing a fix to fully reboot your phone or wipe your phone and start over and reload everything isn't really a great fix. So hopefully they're able to fix that with a software update and we'll see that hopefully with 14.1 or maybe another update in the future. And I would love to see macOS Big Sur pretty soon. But let me know what you're looking most forward to at the iPhone event. Expect the iPhone 12. I did a separate video on all of that with four different models, what to expect, the prices, and everything else. I'll link that in the description like I normally do. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link that in the description as well. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.